May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O Lord. Well, it's been a long time coming for both the church and my family, and we couldn't be happier that today has finally arrived. You know, one of the things that fascinated me about the search process at Community Church of Glen Rock was the way in which ideas about ministry seemed to flow back and forth. It wasn't a matter of racking my brain for ideas. My conversations with the search committee were very fluid, and there was a distinct sense of give and take. We seemed to be on the same page, and I had a very strong sense that the Spirit was guiding me in our discussions. There was a reassurance that was quite comforting. Everything felt right. And no, I haven't changed my mind now that I'm 2 weeks into the job. In short, I feel truly blessed to be here with you, and am tremendously grateful for what I have. We don't always feel that way in life, myself included. Quite often we take for granted all that we are blessed with. We lose sight of the abundance that we are given, and we fail to acknowledge God's providence at work in the world. We would do well to remind ourselves of how blessed we truly are. Many of you, I am sure, have heard these statistics before, yet I always find it beneficial and tremendously humbling to hear again. If you have food in your fridge, clothes on your back, a roof over your head, and a place to sleep, you are richer than 75% of the world. If you have some money in the bank, your wallet, a little spare change, you are among the top 8% of the wealthiest in the world. If you woke up this morning with more health than illness, you are more blessed than the million people who will not survive this. If you have never experienced the danger of bodily agony of imprisonment or torture or the horrible pangs of starvation, you are luckier than 500 million people who are alive and suffering today. And if you can read, you're more fortunate than 3 billion people who cannot read at all. So what does it mean to live with abundance? In today's scripture, Paul lays out 2 great qualities of Christian life. The first is that a Christian life is filled with joy. A Christian life is filled with joy. Even though he was awaiting his own likely persecution and death in prison, Paul was reassuring the Philippians who were setting out on their own struggles of a new Christian way of life. His advice, having weighed all that he had been through, was that they should rejoice. Sure, there would be challenges and persecutions that they would face on their journey. Yet Paul, having encountered all of this himself already, is still able to say, rejoice. Why? Our sense of Christian joy does not rely on any earthly circumstances. Its source comes from the presence of Christ in our lives. If we can remember the coming triumph of Christ, then we will never lose sight of the hope and the joy. If we acknowledge that life is short, that we wish for God in our own lives. When we approach life with this frame of mind, we become much more aware of all that we have instead of all we have not. Paul tells us not to worry, but to take everything to God in prayer. The key word here is everything. Everything. A child can take anything great or small to a parent, knowing that a parent will have their best interest in mind. In much the same way, we should be able to take anything to God in prayer and thanksgiving. We can take all our troubles, forgiveness for the past, challenges of the present, the need for guidance in the future. And we can share our joys with God also. How about that? Share our joys with God also. We can bring prayers for ourselves as well as for others to God. The prophet Khalil Gibran once said, "You pray in your distress and in your need. Would that you might pray also in the fullness of your joy and in your days of abundance." Whatever our prayers may be, they must always be accompanied by thanksgiving. That means giving thanks through our tears and sorrows, as well as in our laughter and our joys. In doing so, we give ourselves over completely to God's will in our lives. When we pray, we must remember the love of God, the wisdom of God, and the power of God, all of which together will guard our hearts. Finally, Paul tells us that we need to focus on what is true, just, honorable, pure, pleasing, commendable, excellent, or worthy of praise in life. In other words, we need to set our thoughts on the finer things in life and not be misguided in our understanding of what it is that truly matters. It is frequently said that if you think about something often enough, eventually, it might come to pass. Focus on something repeatedly, and sooner or later, it becomes a natural train of thought. This church is one of the finer things in life. There is much that we can focus on, and like anything else in life, if you dig deep enough, you might be able to find something you don't agree with. We can find solace, though. We can find solace if we take the advice Paul gives to the Philippians. For there is far more here that is true, just, honorable, pure, pleasing, commendable, excellent, worthy of praise. So I ask you, to rejoice in this church. Whether you've been attending the community church of Glen for 50 years, or whether it is your first visit with us, see the abundance that God has blessed this church with, and all of us who have the opportunity to be a part of it. Take a look around you. And tell me, what do you see? Views? Pulpit? Piano? Organ? Stained glass windows? Lights? They're all things. Go beyond that, though. And what do you see? Pastor? Choir? Congregation? Music director? You can see all of these people in any church across the country every Sunday. Certainly the relationship you have with each of them is going to color your observations. Do this past weekend. This past weekend, a friend of ours came out from the city to visit us for the afternoon. We took him on a tour of the facilities and were the only ones here when we entered the sanctuary. I found it fascinating to watch him. He sat down in that pew right there on the center aisle. Then he said, "Wow, this is beautiful. What a great space. You definitely get the sense that you're in a holy and sacred place. But at the same time, the space is also filled with a vibrant energy. It feels very much open and alive, even with no one in here." He had conveyed the exact same feelings that I had when I first saw the sanctuary. How many of you sense the same thing when you walk in here through these doors? Are we a good match for this sanctuary? Are we vibrant and alive in our lives? Do we rejoice in the abundance of God and what God has blessed us with? I'm not making any guarantees today, but my intention is to bring you a message each week that is as vibrant, open, and alive as this space that we worship in today. Years ago, there was a rock band named Steppenwolf. How many of you have ever heard of Steppenwolf? How many of you remember their song, Born to Be Wild? Not exactly a choir repertoire, right? Okay. So Steppenwolf was not a Christian band, but their songs, like so many of that era, often carried interesting messages. And in this particular song, Steppenwolf declared, "I don't want to be like everybody else. I was born to be different than others. I was born to be wild and free." In that 60s song of rebellion, Steppenwolf touched on a truth that both the Bible and Paul have taught us for nearly 2,000 years. As Christians, we weren't born to be like everybody else. We were born to be different. We were born to be free from the restrictions of this world, if only we believe. We are meant to invite God into everything in our lives and filled with joy, focused on the finer things in life. Luke 10:10 says, "I have come that they may have life, and that they might have it more abundantly." We live in a beautiful community. Rejoice. We can easily get to New York, but you don't have to live there. Rejoice. We have a sacred and vibrant sanctuary. Rejoice. We have family here and one another. Rejoice. We have a wonderful campus with dynamic programs and a dedicated staff. Rejoice. We have tremendous opportunities. Rejoice. We have plenty of work to do. Rejoice. We have hope. We have life. We have faith. We have God. Rejoice. 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 Let us pray. Gracious God, help us to realize that our abundance is in you. Let us rejoice in all we have been blessed with. For you are the great provider. You are the Holy One. You are the Magnificent who lives and reigns forever.